The god and goddess Meru are beautiful beings of light who worked over Lake Titicaca for many, many, many years to enlighten mankind. And as we understand it, on 12/21/12, not quite 12 full years ago, when we were in Peru, very close to Bolivia, under the retreat of Lake Titicaca of the god and goddess Meru, there was the passing of the torch at the end of the Mayan calendar, and the god and goddess Meru ascended to the sun of our system. Helios and Vesta ascended to the center of our galaxy, basically, and then Lonello and Claire de Lis, or Mother, and their ascended light bodies took over the retreat of the god and goddess Meru. Now this, at least the last part that I just shared, that was prophesied quite a while ago. And it's interesting that it occurred at the end of that cycle. David Wilcock and others have talked about various cycles of the ages, and a 25,000 plus year cycle. And it's interesting that when certain alignments occur, changes also occur spiritually in the Ascended Master realms of light. So what do you think will happen tomorrow? Will there be any shift? Will there be some sort of dynamic occurring where on Mother's birthday, which happens to be tomorrow, there will be new opportunities for us? As I heard it in this heart stream, we have to be the sun. We have to be the one. We have to model being sun-like for the evolutions that look to us as initiates. I think this was a very important and pretty epic heart stream. It kind of codified in my consciousness, my mind, a lot of what I feel Mother's mission was while embodied, and now what it is with Lonello over Lake Titicaca, and what we are called to do to be that light, to be those solar representatives. So one of the major initiations within our movement was the release of the Vesta Solar Rosary, which we just gave, and El Morya's book, An Advanced Studies of the Himanora, and these go hand in glove to share with humanity the importance of being sun-like, being the sun, and this is our destiny, to be sons of God, S-U-N-S and S-O-N-S, sons or daughters or sons of God. So the god and goddess Meru share today that we can focus on being sun-like. We can focus on being sunny, having a sunny disposition, having a consciousness wed to the sun, which means that you are always radiating light. So no matter what you're doing, outwardly or inwardly, you're radiating this beautiful golden aura of loveliness, of peace, of harmony, of grace, of divine wisdom, all the virtues that the sun emanates all the time. So the teachings of Omar Mikhail Ivanhoe coming unto us, to humanity, from when he began teaching as a master, really, in France for the last almost 50 years of his life, were an imperative to meditate with the sun in the morning in silence, to imbibe the vibrations, the frequencies of the sun, the virtues that the sun emanates every day. Even if you can't see the sun physically, you can still meditate at the dawn before the sunrise and then through the sunrise, and have inscribed within your consciousness and your auric field the great solar light that will serve you well on your path and whatever you're doing. As I heard it from Mother in this heart stream, we all require to really study to show ourselves approved unto God. How many times did she say that as Elizabeth Clare Prophet in many of her sermons? I've heard it dozens and dozens of times. And it's imperative that some who have not really attended these Meru classes consider doing so, because the current revelatory teachings through Meru University are beautiful. they are kind of the core of the new progressive revelation. In addition to the heart streams, they are concentrated fire, they are concentrated wisdom. And I can tell you that in preparing for this upcoming class, there's just amazing things that are on the edge, ready to be released to the planet and to the world. And as these teachings come forth, which are progressive revelation, new revelation, new understanding, it's like a shift occurs in the world at an etheric level. Anytime a true messenger, doesn't matter who that person is, comes forth, a messiah, a messenger, a prophet, a teacher, who has new teachings or new revelations, a shift occurs in the architecture of the earth, in the etheric blueprint of our planet, and it accommodates the new frequencies or energies that we're all meant to picture, objectify, and manifest. So that's why I think these classes that I've been teaching, or the masters through me and others have been teaching, are so important, because they are game changers. They are catalysts toward higher consciousness, solar awareness, divine understanding, and self-realization. They're catalysts for that. So please, if you haven't attended many Meru University classes, if you don't think you have the funds, contact our Meru University team. Say, is there anything you can do to allow me to attend? I just can't afford it. I'm on a fixed income. I think we should look into making them available for everybody at some level, because they are so important. And I don't really desire to keep the teachings away from people who don't have the funds. So maybe our Meru University team and our leadership can talk and say, what can we do to accommodate people who heretofore haven't really attended virtually anything because they don't have the funds? I really feel that it's important. When Jesus taught on the hillsides, he didn't take up collections and say, you know, you have to pay for this before I teach. He just taught freely. So let's consider what we can do to help. To follow this teaching, to be sun-like, to me, is one of the most important teachings that we have through our movement. To be the sun, to be a son of God, to be a solar light to the planet, because you're feeding the new frequencies of Aquarius dawning to then be broadcast throughout the earth to awaken people, to quicken them, to enlighten them, illumine them, and ultimately for them to be self-realized. So if we do our part, no matter what else we do physically, whatever our job or vocation is, if we are that light of the sun, that is part of our purpose. I heard that in this heart stream today. Whatever we're doing outwardly, great. Praise God. You may be serving people, you may be healing people, all important. You may be teaching people, you may be helping people in many different ways. To be the sun, to be the son of God, to be that light is really our primary purpose and charge. It is our charge. Because when you are that light, when your aura is brimming with divine fire and radiance, you are actually spiritually benefiting every sentient being, and you are illuminating the world. You're helping to solve the problems of the world. You're helping to quash ignorance and to help people through crises just by being that light. Because why? We're all one. We're all part of the same one God. We're all yoked together. We're tied together through the greater auric field of the earth. I mean, we're all living in the same atmosphere, right? So we may as well get along. We may as well do our best to love everyone, to cherish every life stream, no matter who they are, where they are on the path, even if they don't seem to be on the path that we're on, love them anyway. You know, love them with grace, love them with joy, love them with the simple things of life. Being sun-like is so important that it should be a preeminent tenet of our church, of our organization, our movement, our community. We're not supposed to be churchy, yet we are technically a church. But a church is a community. So we're really more of a community. To be sun-like is like a command. It's an imperative. It is our cause célèbre, you know, are called celeb. If every one of us becomes a sun, we won't have any problems with supply. We won't have any issues with personal problems between people because you live the golden rule because you're golden. And so I think just this simple teaching of being sun-like is so crucial that I'd like this message to be shared in simple little ways, even snippets of this teaching going into YouTube and, you know, those shorts or whatever they're called. Get this teaching out. It's part of why we are who we are. It's part of our mission. It's part of our vision. It's part of our point of self-mastery. You know, if we can't be sun-like, we're not following God, because God is pure light, pure sunniness, pure joy, pure harmony, and all the virtues that can exist anywhere. That's God. So if we are trying to be like God, then we will become sun-like, and we'll follow El Morya's teaching in his book, Advanced Studies of the Human Aura. We'll follow Mark and Mother. We'll follow the God and Goddess Meru, Helios and Vesta, all these great masters of wisdom, and being fully enlightened, first awakened, then illumined, then enlightened, and then self-realized, naturally we then move into the transfiguration, the resurrection, the ascension. It's a natural process, and it's a beautiful thing. So I kind of just had to get that off my chest, so to speak, because I think we forget how simple the path really is when you boil it down to the essentials, right? Live the golden rule, be godlike, love, and everything else will fall into place properly at the right time with the right people at the right place.